new. We can leave your friends behind. Cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go where we want to, place where they will never find. And we can act like we come from out of this world, leave the real one far behind. Welcome back to WSC Live, Episode 3. I'm your host, Alex, and I'm lonely. We have a great show for you today, and we'll be running through some of the safety procedures we do here at Westco. As you may have heard, we've gotten plenty of chances to put these procedures to use so far, and we're eager to see how our fellow students feel about these. First, we're sending you off to Steven with a very safe episode of Talking to Doody.
Hello. Today I'm Steven Doody, and we're going to focus on some safety hazards with my man Chase.
Hey.
Why, hello.
Hello. What do you have? Got any questions?
Of course.
What do you need?
So if the school were to get flooded, what would you do?
I would buy a yacht and then put it on the campus so everyone can have it.
I think that's a beautiful idea. Would you ever rent the hall pass to get the pool on the third floor?
I can't swim.
Would you get a kayak and put it on the pool on the third floor?
I still can't swim.
Oh, no. All right. Thank you. Hello, I'm Steven Doody. And who am I with?
Carly Quartz.
And have you ever been in a fire drill?
This is not good. I have not been in a fire.
Have you ever been in a fire drill?
I have been in a fire drill.
Are they fun?
No. I mean, we get out of class, so that's okay.
How about an earthquake drill?
I have been in an earthquake drill.
Which do you prefer?
Fire, because you get to go outside. Earthquake, you just hide under a desk and you're really cramped.
That's agreeable.
That's valid?
That's valid.
Okay.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Hello, I'm Steven Doody, and who am I with?
Mr. Jack Martin.
Jack Martin. And do you know any safety hazards about the fires?
I couldn't tell you myself, Doody.
Do you know any safety hazards about earthquakes?
Get under a desk, Doody.
Do you have any safety hazards about flooding?
Roll your pants up, Doody.
If the power goes out.
Turn the flashlight on, Doody.
If we're on lockdown.
Yeah, I don't got nothing for that one, dude.
You're
going to hide on that one.
Well, alrighty. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Hello, I'm Steven Doody, and who am I with?
Bella.
And if a school shooter were to walk on campus, what would you do?
Probably run and leave.
Sounds like a valid excuse. If the power were to go out, what would you do?
I have no idea. Probably just hide somewhere. No clue.
There was some massive floods at West County. What would you do?
I would dip. I would leave again.
You can drive.
Drive away.
What if the car is flooded, though, with water?
I would get to the highest point, like the main building, go to the top.
Yeah, swimming pool on the roof, sure.
Yep.
All right, well, thank you.
Yep.
Hey, West County, I'm Everett, that's Co behind the camera, and today we're asking students what song they're listening to. Yo, what song are you listening to?
Well, I'm listening to No Debate by Nav featuring Young Thug. Woke up
feeling like a million bucks. Oh, yeah.
What song are you listening to?
I'm listening to Thriller by Michael Jackson.
All right, what song are you listening to?
The battle theme of Final Fantasy VI.
All right.
What song you got on? I got Seek and Destroy from Metallica.
All right, nice. Yo, what song you got on, bro?
I'm listening to Sweater Weather.
Wait, hold up. Sweater Weather?
Okay. Sweater Weather.
By the way, neighborhood. What song you got on, bro?
I'm listening to Sessions by G Herbo. Just ran it up,
couldn't even complain. I was. All right, cool. Yo, what song you listening to, Kat? I ain't going outside today. Oh.
Glad to hear our fellow students are still listening to some lit music during these trying times. Now we have an inside look at our most recent fire drill for you.
How does this make you feel?
It makes me feel really good inside.
Good stuff.
Yeah. You are good stuff.
I know.
Oh, good.
Yes. What are your thoughts?
On this?
Yep.
I'm just done. I gotta be out of math, so I'm not complaining.
Were you aware that this was gonna be happening?
The teacher told us like 3 minutes beforehand. Wow. So yeah, it was just kind of like a waiting to go.
And how do you think it's going so far? How quick do you think this has been? Do you think that if you actually got out at this speed, if this were a real fire, that you would still be alive?
I would be burned to a crisp.
Exactly. What line are you going to, Jack?
I am going to line a C. It's like
a C. So going to the C instead of the F.
Yeah,
man. That's not very nice. Yeah. Yeah, what are your thoughts on this?
There's a lot of people out here.
There's a lot of fires!
Yep.
Big fire going
fire.
On.
Do you think you'd be alive right now if this was a real fire?
Well, what if the fire was on the field?
Yeah, where would we evacuate? Where would we go?
What if there was a school shooter? They just
said... Exactly. Happy birthday, Mary.
Thanks, Lars.
What are your thoughts on this?
It's really crowded, and it's warm outside, and the sun's in my face.
Do you think you'd be alive if there was a real fire?
I'd hope so, but I don't really know. I don't think I tried that hard.
Do you think that with how many people there are, you would have gotten out in time?
I guess, but my teacher had no clue what to do. He was like, I don't know where we're going. So that was nice.
It's always good when even the teachers don't know what they're doing.
Yes.
Oh, hey guys. Hi. Do you guys feel safe out here?
Yeah, it's pretty dope.
If this was a real, like, fire, you know, do you think you would have made it out alive and in time?
Most likely, yes.
I think I would. I mean, personally, fire doesn't affect me. I would have come out alive no matter what. I feel like the process of getting out here was pretty quick. All the students were, like, in fairly file order. There wasn't too much cramping, although I did get here in the beginning.
How different did it feel from when we did this before the consolidation?
It feels about the same. I wasn't too cramped. I got here pretty early, so I got here before most of, like, the crowd, so I don't think I can give you a fair, like, view of what was the actual truth, but, you know, like, it was okay for me.
But you think that this was a success overall?
I'd say yes, from what I saw.
Good. We are going through the faster gate. It's for sure faster. Trust Randy. Always trust Randy. Never trust anyone but Randy. Randy supremacy. Supreme leader, Randy. Oh, hey, Brendan. You want to be interviewed?
Yes.
Did you feel like this was a success overall?
Yeah, I think there were a lot of people that faked their last name, but otherwise, I think it was nice and smooth, and I got that out there pretty quick, so.
If you had to choose a new last name for fire drills, what would you pick?
Probably like Z, so I could just be on the end and then just leave right away, instead of being right in the middle.
You'd prefer that over like hanging out with people during it?
Well, a lot of people just go to a different line and hang out with me anyways, so yeah, I think it'd be fine. I think it's fine.
Everybody just goes to Brendan wherever he goes.
It's true.
Oh, and then we got Callum and Levi. How safe did you guys feel during that?
I felt so safe.
Very safe.
So safe.
As safe as I've ever felt in my life.
Did you guys see any clear inefficiencies in it versus the fire drills that happened when we were not consolidated?
Absolutely none.
It was much better.
The field was more difficult.
Freshman year, we had kids pulling the fire alarm just randomly. That was fun.
That's fair. But you do think that this will better prepare us for if we do have a real fire in the future?
Unless the football field's on fire.
Yeah, that was our only complaint. Like, what if the football field's on fire? What are we gonna do? Where are we gonna go?
Then we'd probably just go to the gym.
We'll feel very unsafe if the football field would be on fire.
Is that right, Kel?
But what if the football field caught on fire after we got to the football field?
That would be a problem too.
That would be a problem. It would probably cause mayhem.
We'd all die and not be very safe.
We'd all die, but we won't.
Wow, that was great. Some might even say it was fire. Two lockdowns and a day off school. Numerous safety drills and assemblies. It's been a crazy year for us safety-wise. As a bit of insider info for you, our next fire drill is November 17th. On another note, this week is our football team's last game and then the start of winter sports. We want to wish good luck to our football team against Kolton Lumen. We also want to wish luck to our seniors on the last dance with the high school football. Also, today's the premiere of West County Theater's fall play, She Kills Monsters. Look at it. It's right there. For more information, go to the West County Theater's Instagram. That's all we have for today. We hope you enjoyed the show and learned a little something new. Remember to like the video and subscribe to the channel to keep up on WSC Live. I'm Alex. Bye.
Cause your friends don't dance, and if they don't dance, well, they're no friends of mine. See, we can go.